Hi guys, this is Zoro. Welcome back into my channel. Today I've got another unboxing video because I bought another knife. This time from a friend of mine. So there is no actual box to open because this is used. Still a new knife, but a little bit used. And it's a Survive GSO 4.1, and I will open the box right then. So I have bought this from a friend of mine, which is also a collector of Survive knife. This is the classic Survive box made in USA. This is the knife. There is nothing, I believe, under this. No? Okay. That's all. And let me check what's is inside here. That's a Torx T25, which I believe is the... Yes. It's the correct one for the screws on the end of the Survive. So this is the Survive GSO 4.1. Sorry about the light, but today it's raining and there is no actually sun outside. So the light isn't the best. This was modified by my friend. He put this belt loop on the sheath, so this wasn't original, made by Survive. This is the original one that he turned on the other side, but the sheath is the original one, of course. This is the knife. It's used, but it's basically brand new. There is a few spots on the edge, but nothing too serious. It's made in CPM 3V. Delta is the name of the heat treatment made by Survive. The shape of the handle is very well done, fits the end really perfect. I love the spear point design of the blade, and I also love all the details made by Survive, such as the hole for the paracord under the scales of the handle. And yeah, I think that this is a very perfect bushcraft knife. The classic 4-inch blade, very thin on the edge, very well done, classic, easy to use, easy to carry with you in a backpack or something similar. And I think that this is a classic. And it's a very good knife. The design of the blade, it's also very simple and very easy to use with the jimping for your thumb. And I think that there are a few knife that can beat this one for classic bushcraft use. I think that the probably the Bark River Aurora or the TRC South Pole are some good alternative to this blade, or the Bark River Bravo One, maybe the LT version, or the Ganni by Bark River, or some other classic knife are the Volkswagen F1, which I have got right here for size comparison. So this is the my very old Volkswagen F1. I've got this knife for several years, probably 10 years, 10, 12 years, something like that. Let me focus on the knife. So this is the classic Volkswagen F1 laminated with VG10, and this is the Survive GSO 4.1. You can check the thickness. Of course, the Volkswagen is more thick on the spine. The Volkswagen is a stick tang blade construction with the classic handle made by Volkswagen in rubber materials. They are very similar on the handle, on the sides of the handle, similar, but they are different mostly on the blade because the F1 is a little bit smaller, convex zero, but more thick on the spine, while the Survive is some sort of a saber grind, flat, with flat bevel, very thin on the edge, but with the classic micro V edge. And the tip is also different. The Survive is a spear point. But I think that this will be a good challenge to see some sort of a test between these two knives. Because they are both classic, good knife, and very well done and made. I think that also a challenge between the Barkriver Aurora or the TRC South Pole would be a very nice challenge. Maybe we will do some sort of video, something like that, a challenge between this knife in the future. I don't have all the knife that you have seen in my previous video. I have sold a lot of knife, sold and buy a lot of knife, but I got my favorite ones and the knife that I love to have or to use, such as the Volkswagen F1, which I've got for 12 years. And yes, but I have sold a lot of knife and things that you have seen in my channel, so I don't have everything that passed through my collection over the years. I've always sold a lot of things to buy new things, but I still have got several knives to do a comparison or a challenge. And yeah, that is all for today, and we will see in the next video. Bye.